Hello, I'm Martin from MLabs. Today we're going to check out Cardano Open Oracle Protocol. This project allows you to publish fact statements to the Cardano blockchain to be used by scripts as inputs. The tutorial starts out with installing Nix, and it shows how to do this manually. However, I recommend the Determinant Systems Nix installer, as this gives an overall smoother experience. Once we have Nix installed, we'll make a directory for the tutorial and then cd into it. Next, we're going to run Nix develop to start the development environment. This project comes with a handy development environment, which has all the tools we need to run an experiment on a local cluster. Here's how to start a local Cardano cluster. As the cluster starts, I'm going to open another terminal. Looks like the cluster is running now. The local cluster script created some wallets for us, so we're going to export them as environment variables. Here we can see the exported PubKey hashes. Next, we're going to initialize the co-op protocol. We can check the state. Looks like the protocol is initialized. Now we are going to issue some authentication tokens to the authenticator wallets. Looks like the redeemer tokens were minted. Now we're going to mint the cert and the authentication token. Cool. Next, we redistribute the authentication tokens to the authenticator wallets. And check the state again. Looks like now we have a certificate. Next, we're going to run a Transaction Builder gRPC service. This service takes transaction requests and actually builds the Cardano transactions. We're going to generate a key pair for it, and then run the TX Builder service. Okay, looks like the service is running. I'm going to open another terminal. Next, we want to run a fact statement store service. This service stores fact statements for us. We prepare and initialize the service, and also add some fact statements into the store. We check the database to see that the fact statements are indeed there. Cool. Now we start the service. Next up, we're going to run the publisher service. This is quite easy as well. Users can interact with this service. This service will interact with the other services we set up in order to publish fact statements. Next, we will publish a fact statement with the publisher service. Here's a request to do so. We save this request and then submit it to the service. We can check the response for the info. And it looks like we have published some fact statements with the following IDs. And no errors. The response from the publisher service includes Cardano transaction, then we can sign. First we translate it so Cardano CLI can understand it. Then we sign the transaction and submit it. The transaction was successfully submitted, so we should see that in the protocol state. And indeed, we have some fact statements here. Now that the fact statements have been published, we can use them in our dApp by referencing the desired fact statement UTXOs. After some time, we can garbage collect the obsolete fact statement UTXOs. Let's check how that is done. Our example fact statements are considered immediately obsolete, so we should be able to garbage collect them. We make a request to the publisher service and then get the response. It shows that we have the following obsolete fact statement IDs. And also returns a transaction that allows us to garbage collect them. We're going to take that response, sign the transaction, and then submit it via Cardano CLI. Now we can check the state for fact statements and see that they have been removed. We can also garbage collect obsolete certificate UTXOs. The goal of this project is to be able to use fact statements in consumer dApps. And the tutorial includes some documentation on how to do this, including an example consumer validator script. That's right here. Thank you and have fun building dApps.